Hello friends, what is the color of this ball in my hand? We all would agree that it is red. But whether your pet dog would agree on this, believe me, for your pet dog, this color is not red and it would be of this color. Why? To understand this, first we should know what is this so-called color. Is it something real or only our perception? When I see this ball through my eyes, what is actually happening? Some white light is reaching this ball from somewhere and some part of this light is reflected by the ball, and this light reflected from the ball is reaching my eyes and I see it as red. But the same reflected light, when reaching the eyes of a dog, it see it as this color. Let's look closely into this light reaching our eyes. Is there anything red or any color in it? Nothing of that sort. It consists of an oscillating electric field and magnetic field traveling like a wave, and so is called an electromagnetic wave. Then, what about the light reflected from another ball which we see as blue? That also is made up of similar oscillating fields, and the only differences between the two are in the speed of oscillation and in the distance covered during one oscillation. In red light, the fields are oscillating around 430 trillion times a second, and in blue light around 650 trillion times per second. And the number of oscillations done by the wave in 1 second is what we call as the frequency of light. And in red light, during one oscillation, the wave covers a distance of 650 nanometer, or the length of one wave or so-called wavelength is 650 nanometer. For blue light, this is 460 nanometer. So technically, when we see a red color from anywhere, it's just that an electromagnetic wave of wavelength 650 nanometer is reaching our eyes and we perceive it as red. But the same light is perceived by a dog as some other color. To unravel this further, we should check what is happening inside our eyes and that of dogs. Inside our eyes, in the retina, there are some things called cones which are responsible for detecting the wavelength or color of incoming light. When light falls on this, they can sense it and send signals to brain. And there are three types of cones in a human eye. The sensitivity of a particular cone is highest for a particular wavelength, or the intensity of signals sent to brain is highest for a particular wavelength for a cone. Out of the three types of cones that we have, the sensitivity of the first one is highest for blue light, second one is highest for green light, and the third one for red light. How do they sense the wavelength or color of a light? Here lies the answer. Based on the sensitivity levels, all cones can send up to 100 types of signals to the brain. For example, say our brain receives a yellow light of wavelength 580 nanometer. It stimulates the blue cone to this level, green cone to this level, and red cone to this level. And brain receives all three signals of different levels, and this is a unique combination, and it understands that we have received yellow color. Almost all animals except apes and monkeys have only two cones in their eyes, and the two cones in dogs are corresponding to blue and yellow. That means they can see only those colors which can be made by combination of blue and yellow. This is the spectrum of colors that humans can see, and this is what dogs can see. Red, green, etc. are not there. When we see red, they see this color. So two balls like this, which look different to us, may look same to them. So never ever try to train your pet dog to differentiate such colors. He simply does not have the capability for that. But try the same thing with birds or fish, they will outsmart you. They have four cones in their eyes. That means the spectrum or colors that they can see is more than that of humans. They can see many colors, including that we cannot see. You might have seen a similar scene. And if you thought that the red color was making the bull angry, sorry to say that it's baseless and it's just a myth. A bull cannot distinguish red color as it has only two cones. So it should be something else that makes it angry. That's it for today.
Thank you for watching. Subscribe, click the bell button, and support us. Signing off, Science for Common Man.